Now in the literature, there is an alankara also. Upama, a beautiful simile you give. A good simile you should give. So wonderful simile. Vagartha vivasam pruptav. Kalidasa, upama kalidasasya. It is not our upama, morning upama, it is not. Upama means simile. So Kalidasa is well known for his upama. Upama alankaram, there are only two poets. One is Valmiki and then Kalidasa. Only two poets. Bas, that's all. So that is a very great poet, Kalidasa. You know, this finger is called Anamika. This finger is called Anamika. Why it is called Anamika? A poem is there for that. Suddenly I remembered. Mahakavinam Ganana Prasange. Let us see how far I can remember the poem. Mahakavinam Ganana Prasange. There was a discussion, Prasanga. So in that discussion they started counting Mahakavis. Who are the Mahakavis? Great poets. So Mahakavinam Ganana Prasange Kanishthikadhishthita Kalidasa. So how we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is how we count. It is always 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that we count. So let us start the count of great poets. Kalidasa. So now Kalidasa is sitting on this finger, the little finger. Kanishthika Adhishthita Kalidasa. Now the little finger is taken care of. Now the second poet should come. Tattulya adhyapi tattulya kavehe abhavat. Even today, a kavi, a poet of equal caliber is not there. Therefore, Anamika sarthavati babhuva. So, Anamika, it got its name very appropriately. There is no nama for it. Kanishthika got a nama, Kalidasa, it has got a nama. That is Anamika, yasya nama navidyate, navidyate nama yasyaha. Sa Anamika. So Anamika name, whosoever gave that name, it is very appropriate name. Like that they say. So Kalidasa is a very great poet. And the poetry beauty is Upama Alankara. Upama is the Alankara. And then there is another Alankara, Rupaka Alankara. Rupaka is allegory. So the entire poem is allegory. That is Rupaka Alankara. Then there is one more Alankara. All these shlokas, the entire shlokas which I have told today, 3 or 4, they come under that alankara. It is called Swabhavokti Alankara. You must have heard, some of the students of Sanskrit, they know it. So Swabhavokti Alankara. So you describe a beautiful nature's situation just as it is. A beautiful situation you should describe. Not some dirty situation just as it is. That doesn't become Swabhavokti Alankara. A beautiful situation of the nature. You don't add anything, just describe as it exists. So, yathavat uktihi, as it is you present. That is a great blessing it is. So it is not easy just to present a thing as it is. You require a lot of imagination and words and all that. That is an alankara by itself. So here, the movement of the elephant, the progress of the elephant in the forest, and then it's entering into the pool, and enjoying the cool waters of the pool, everything is presented in Swabhavokti Alankaram. So you see this shlokam, it comes under Swabhavokti. So, Vigahya tasmin in that pool, Vigahya, it took a dip. So it just took a dip completely. Dipped its head and came up. Because heat is there, you know. It is unable to bear the heat. So vigashyatasmin. So first thing is a dip in the pool. Then having done that, vigashya means having done that, then it is drinking the water. Papau nikamam, nikamam, to its complete satisfaction. So as much water it wanted. So you come in a hot sun, and so they give you cold water. Cold water they should give, not equally hot water. So cold water, refrigerator water only they should give. When you come in the hot sun. Then they give in a glass, so drink it. They pour it, again drink it, again pour, again drink. So like that you drink, that is nikamam papau ammaya. So So like that you get a feeling of satiation. That is what is called nikamam papau. Papau means it drank. Nikamam papau. So having dipped first, then it drank. What? Amrutambu. It is not, ambu is jalam, water. It is a nectar-like jalam. Amrutambu papau. And that water is not a muddy water. It is very clean water. Nirmalam amrutambu. Nirmalam, not muddy water. Good water. Not only that, it is like some extra good qualities are there for that water. Hema ravindotpala renu vasitam. So the golden colored lotuses, Hema Aravinda, and Utpala, lilies, these are there in that pool. So their pollen is also mixed up with that water. So Renu Vasitam. Vasitam means fragrant, made fragrant. So it is made fragrant by the pollen of golden lotuses and lilies. Hema Aravindotpala Renu Vasitam. So that type of a water it is. So it drank papau nikamam. How it drank? Nija pushkarodhrutam. Pushkara is the trunk. So it lifts the water with its trunk. It fills the trunk with water and bends the trunk and puts in its mouth and fills the mouth with water and gulps it. Again trunk goes out and fills the water, some 4-5 liters of water, and again put in. So like that, nija pushkarodhrutam, papau nikamam. Papau is lit. Lit, pibati, you know. Pibati. Pibati, pibataha, pibanti. That is lut. Lit is a papau, papatuhu, papuhu. That is lit. Past tense. Past tense. Yeah. There are three tenses for past. Lit, lung, and lung. Lit is the most difficult. Lit is difficult. Lung is easy of all. Lung is even more difficult. I mean, difficult in the sense you have to by heart. You have to study well. Papau. You know, bhudhatu babhuva, you know, babhuva. That is lit. Papau is like that. Papau nikamam nija pushkarodhutam. While it is drinking, when its thirst is satiated, it started spraying itself with these waters. Atmanamadhihi snapayan snapayan. It is giving a bath for itself. So atmanam snapayan. With the waters, it is giving a bath for itself. So these elephants, they take a nice bath because they have got that trunk which can carry 4-5 liters of water in each stroke. So it takes that much water and put on its head, on the sides, everywhere it can spray this water. It can direct the water wherever it wants. So it can take a very efficient bath. I have seen the elephant's bath. So in Guruvayur, you may see it when you go there. So atmanamadbhihi snapayam. You need not help it to take bath. It takes its own bath very efficiently. Atmanamadbhihi. Whereas a cow is there, suppose a cow is there. Goseva, if you do, you know it. So a cow, you have to do cleaning and all that for it. Otherwise, it doesn't know how to take bath. Because cow is a very docile animal. It doesn't have the benefit of a trunk and all that. So it requires help from us. Whereas for an elephant, it takes its bath. You allow it, it takes its bath. Snapayan. Gatak klamaha. So all its exhaustion is gone. Klamaha is exhaustion. Tiredness. So that is gone. Because in the summer you get tired walking and all that. So very comfortable. So this is Svabhavokti Alankara. Very interesting slokam. So we'll go to the next slokam also. Svapushkarena Udhruta Shikarambubhihi Nipayayan Saunsnapayan Yathagruhi. Grunikarenuh kalabhamscha durmadah nachashtakrichram krupanah ajamayaya. So the allegory is presented in a very clear way here. Yatha Gruhi. So the poet is not hiding anything anymore. Nothing is left for suggestion. It is open. Yatha Gruhi. Gruhi means a man of the world. A man of the world. How a man of the world behaves. So people go to Uti with family, with a load of money, with a bundle of money in the pocket. So they get down and then take a taxi and go to a hotel, a 5-star hotel. So they will be whenever they have to pay something, they take out a bundle and remove one note and give it. One note or two notes and put back the bundle inside. So like that, they have a lot of money to spend. And so they indulge. They go to the bar, this, that, they indulge. Yatha Grihi. So this elephant is like that. He is indulging in carnal pleasures. So svapushkarena udhruta shikaram vibhuhi. So now its tiredness is gone. Thirst is satiated. Its stomach is full. So it is very happy. Now it is playing. So time for play. Svapushkarena udhruta shikaram vibhuhi. It lifts a lot of water with its trunk and makes a spray out of it. Sprays that water. And it makes the other elephants, it gives a bath for other elephants. Snapayan. It gives a bath to the other elephants. Sausnapayan. So for the child elephants are there, small elephants are there, and other female elephants are there, and other male elephants are also, smaller elephants are there. So this is the king. So the king is giving a bath to the all. So it's an enjoyment of a swimming pool party like thing. So samsnapayan nipayayan. So it fills water in its trunk and puts that trunk in the mouth of another elephant and unloads all the water into the mouth of the elephant. So that elephant, without any effort, it can drink water. Nipayayan. It is making the other elephant drink water. So it is playing nicely. So nipayayan, samsnapayan, yatha grihi. Just like a man of the world. So how gruni? Gruni means very arrogant. Gruni, this is one style of the shlokas. Gruni can be applied to the elephant as well as grihi. So gruni gajaha, a proud elephant, like even gruni gruhi, an arrogant grihi. So gruni. And durmadaha means the strength, the physical strength has gone to its head. Durmadaha. It has gone to its head. So these people, young people especially, they misbehave. Especially when their number is more, they misbehave. If they are one or two, they keep quiet. But in the college students especially, so they are strong, they go to gym every day, very strong. So they misbehave. When they see some innocent guy, they show off their strength. We come across in the train when you are traveling. So especially sadhus are at a receiving end occasionally. So there is no protection and all that. Anyway, it is all a part of the life. But they are very arrogant. The strength, the physical strength and the money in the pocket. That is a big strength. So the money in the pocket, he knows he has got quite a good amount of money which he can throw a little at a time. So he knows it, that goes to his head. So now you cannot handle him. That is what is called durmadaha. I cannot describe that word more than this. Durmadaha. We have another usage, durmadandhaha. So he is blind with it. Andhaha. He is not andhaha in a physical way. He is andhaha with durmada. That strength, physical strength and money power and other things, they go to his head and now he is blind. So the other day in Delhi, the fellow has shooted down a lady in the middle of the bar. He is andhaha, durmadaha. Recently Jessica Lal was shot down in between so many people who were dancing and drinking.
He just shot her down then and there. He asked, give me one more peg. She told no. She told no for some reason. Not even said no. She just ignored him. Okay, enough. Like this she ignored. Then he took out his pistol and shoot her down there. She is no more. That is Durmadaha. So, Durmadaha. And the Karenuhu Kalabhamshya Samsnapayan Nipayayan. So, he is giving a bath to the female elephants. And he is making them drink water without any effort. And also for the children. He has got some children also, you know. So he is playing with them. So, Durmadaha, when everything goes to the head, then the adversity which is waiting to pounce upon you, you will not notice it. So, Nachashta Krucharam, Nachashta, he did not know. What? Krucharam. Krucharam is adversity. Adversity. So, a great calamity is going to fall upon him, fall upon his head, like a bolt from the blue. It is going to fall. He did not notice it. Nachashta krucharam krupanaha. That krupanaha is a Vedic word. He gargi atmanam aviditvayaha praiti sa krupanaha. That is the only word. Krupanaha is, that is the only word. There is no other meaning will fit here. Krupanaha means miserly. What miserliness is there? There is no miserliness involved here. So this is the meaning of krupanaha. So that grihi krupanaha. Krupanaha you add to the grihi. So the person has no idea of atmajnanam or ishvara or dharma or culture or goodwill or simple social behavior, reasonable social behavior. None of these things are known to him. He wants his drink. He wants his order to be followed. Bas. Otherwise he will shoot down. So, that is the Durmadaha and that is the fellow who is Krupanaha. So, he has wasted a wonderful opportunity given by Bhagavan in the form of a human birth. Such a person is called Krupanaha. And this elephant is is like that Krupanaha. And hence, it could not recognize a huge calamity that is going to befall on it. So, Nachashta Krucharam Krupanaha Ajamayaya. Why this calamity should come? Because Bhagavan's maya is there. So it is the leela or the play of the Ishvara. He is the karma phala data. He allows you to play. He allows you to indulge. He gives you a very long rope and then he strikes you. So ajamayaya, that is how aja is Ishvara. Ishvara's maya functions like that. He doesn't give you a notice and all that. So he strikes like that. Ajamayaya nachashta krucharam. So finally, there is some purva punya is there. Therefore, it will culminate in shubham only. But then, if we go out of the dharma path, so Bhagavan punishes us. That is the way. We will continue with it tomorrow.